You come with me.
I wrote the scene, and I thought I could go back and change it, but it's done. I can't go back.
Why don't you try to hold it until we get outside?
You were asking me to give up on myself like you gave up on yourself. That's why you told me to do it.
Look, see, I don't know if you should be here, Mary.
You weren't trying to kill him. You wanted to kill me, to keep me here, to keep me from writing the book.
Please don't make a scene. We could talk about this tomorrow.
But something terrible happened. I could feel it when I was writing. I tore something wide open, and now I can't close it. It's spilled out all over the floor.
Okay.
It's out here.
Okay,
it's outside of me. It's spread all over the ground. No, don't touch me. And you listen to me. Something's different. I don't know what it is, but it's not just my problem now. It's going to be your problem too. I know that.
I understand. I've been through this. Now just slow down for a minute and look at me. Okay? Just look at me. Now, you are not the only writer who's lost it, who's lost their grip. A book can become so real, like you are in it. Come on, hey, look at me. Just let me hold you.
No, don't do that. I need you to hear me. You can't do what we did. You can't kill the better part like that.
It's just a story. It's nothing else. Look, are we okay now?
No!
Are we...
Do you see me?
I see that you're hurting. It's a terrible feeling when a story takes you over like that, but you've done the right thing. You've cut out the fat. And now you've got a conflict, you've got some desperation. And if you go back into it, I think you might have a book. I know it's lonely, but I also know that there isn't anything I can do to help you. I think you're gonna have to fight this one on your own. Now, I need to go inside. Go.